Welcome to this module on federalism. In this module, we are going to learn about the features of federalism. What are the key features of federalism? The first feature of federalism is there should be two or more levels of governments. That is the first key feature of federalism. So there should be two or more levels of governments in order to make a division of power between the center and the states. The second key feature is that different tiers of governments govern the same citizens. So we need to know that the different levels of governments, either the central government or the state government, will have to govern, to take care, to administer the same set of citizens. They are not ruling different parts of the country. They are ruling the same citizens on different areas of jurisdiction. Like, for example, the legislation and taxation as well as administration. So they have different tiers of government to govern the same citizens. That is the second key feature of federalism. Now moving to the third one, the jurisdiction of the respective levels of governments are specified by the constitution, so they are constitutionally guaranteed. They don't have any areas where they clash with each other. They have clearly specified areas of jurisdiction by the constitution or within the constitution, so the areas of jurisdiction is constitutionally guaranteed. Moving to the fourth feature, that is the fundamental provisions of the constitution cannot be unilaterally changed by one level of government. Such changes require the consent of both the levels of governments. So it is very, very important provision, because any areas of jurisdiction has to be changed. They need to be consented by both the levels of governments. No particular government can unilaterally change the clauses or the provisions of the constitution. That is the fourth important feature of federalism. Coming to the next important feature, that is courts will have the power to interpret the constitution and explain the powers of the different levels of governments in case if there is any dispute. The highest court acts as an empire to settle the disputes between the both the levels of governments in case if there is any dispute. Moving to the very, very important point, that is the sources of revenue for each level of the government are clearly specified, in such a way that they have the financial autonomy for them. No government can stop the financial resources or decide and declare you have to do like this or command the other government. The sources of revenue for each level of government are clearly specified to ensure their financial autonomy. Now coming to the last point of the key features of federalism, that is the federal system has dual objectives. So what are the dual objectives of federalism? The federalism firstly want to safeguard and promote unity of the country. They want to safeguard the country and they want to promote the unity of the country. These are the prime objectives of the country. While at the same time, they want to accommodate the regional diversity as well. They want to take care of the regional differences which are there in the population. So there are dual objectives for for the federal structure or federal system. One, to safeguard and promote the unity of the country, while at the same time they also want to accommodate the regional diversity of the nation. So these are the key features of federalism. One, two or more levels of government. Two, there are different tiers of governments system, as well as they have their own jurisdiction to govern the same citizens. The constitution provisions are guaranteed by the constitution. No fundamental provisions of the constitution can be changed unilaterally without having the consent of the other governments. If there is any dispute, the courts act as an umpire. There are financial guarantees, or the sources of revenues are guaranteed to ensure its financial autonomy. The federal system thus has dual objectives: one, to safeguard and promote the unity of the country, while also at the same time to accommodate the regional diversity. Hope you all got all the key points of federalism. That's all we have in this module. Stay tuned, we'll catch you in the next module.